各位朋友，接下来为大家介绍的是一个非常好吃的香叶椰丝卷，也叫做龟壳大叶或者是龟蛋蛋。So ladies and gentlemen, the next Nyonya kueh that I would like to show you is a kueh dada or kueh ketayap. This is like a spring roll, green in color with coconut filling inside. It is a very nice pancake. 好，首先我们来看看它的材料。我们需要用到的就是180g 的幼白面粉，就是普通的幼白面粉。So this is 180g of plain flour. You can use super fine, super soft flour.Just put the flour into a mixing bowl， 给它倒在一个碗里面，然后在里面我们要用到的就是半小匙的盐 ，This is half a teaspoon of salt，and you need to have 2 eggs。这边有2粒的鸡蛋，今天用到的鸡蛋就是 Omega Plus 的健康鸡蛋，我们要用到就是一粒半的。我们要用到的就是一粒半的鸡蛋，首先就是把一粒鸡蛋先打下去。Just break one egg into your mixing bowl. We are going to use 1.5. To get another half, this is what you have to do. 我们用到是一粒半的鸡蛋，一粒半就是先把一粒放下去，另外这一粒呢，我们就是先跟它来搅拌均匀。You beat up this egg, one whole egg, until it is...well beaten like this or well mixed, then only you divide into half and put it in. 然后我们才倒进半粒的鸡蛋，这就是拿一粒半鸡蛋的方法。还要用到的就是6片的斑斓叶 ，This is 6 pieces of pandan leaf. 加入350 ml 的水，跟它拿来打，打了以后它就变成了这个斑斓叶的水。跟它来剪成丝 ，put in 350 ml of water and you blend. After that, you strain it to get this 350 ml of pandan juice. 就是这样搅了以后，我们才跟它各过哦，过滤过。这就是我们350 ml 的斑斓叶的水了。好，现在我们就是把这个斑斓叶的水跟这个鸡蛋慢慢慢慢的跟我们的面粉搅拌均匀。This is how you mix.The batter. Put in the eggs and then slowly pour in the pandan juice and you use a whisk and you stir in one direction. As you stir, you slowly pour in the water. 不要把这个水倒进得太快哦。如果你倒进得太快的话，那么这个面粉很容易就起团。You will turn into lumps very, very easily if you add in the water too quickly. Just stir like this in one direction.搅的时候记得哦，要同一个方向来搅哦。好，就是这个样子，同一个方向搅到它非常均匀为止。Just stir in one direction until it is well mixed. 大家请看哦，它做出来的面糊呢就是这样的，是水水的。Can you see? It is very very light. 现在我们就要用一个锡，然后把刚才已经搅好了的面糊倒下去，跟它沥一沥，那么它就会非常非常的滑。Please strain the mixture before you use, so that everything will be very smooth and nice. 如果你上面还有一点粉团的话，就尽量的跟它拿来搅融它哦。Any flour particles here, please press and make sure it is very, very well mixed. To cook the filling, you need to use 3 cups of shredded coconuts. 这就是3杯的百椰丝。When you buy the coconut, make sure you don't want the husk, the black part, so that you look very nice, white and nice. 这椰丝刨的时候，尽量不要刨到它黑色的部分，那么它的椰丝就是白色的。这3杯的椰丝大概就是半粒的椰汁，还要用到就是90g 的椰糖 ，This is 90g of palm sugar, or we call it gula melaka, and also you have about 3 tablespoons of water. 这就是3大匙的水。这个两样东西我们要先跟它来煮一煮，给它融。所以首先呢，我们就是把我们的水倒在一个锅子里面，然后也把我们的椰糖放下去。Just pour the sugar and the water into a pot. and add in half a teaspoon of salt, 加入半小匙的盐，然后把这两样东西跟它拿来煮一煮，把椰糖跟水跟它煮，煮到这个椰糖溶解为止。然后这个时候呢，我们可以加入一片的斑斓叶 ，just put in one piece of pandan leaf and tie into a knot。把斑斓叶放下去，跟它煮一煮。大家请看哈，最要紧的就是你的糖一定要溶哈。如果你的糖不溶的话，那么我们可以加多一点点的水去煮。好，大家请看，这糖已经溶了，现在我们就可以把我们的椰丝放下去了。Now you can add in the coconut. Make sure your sugar has melted before you add in the coconut. Yes, 大家请看哈，这椰丝呢，我们一定要跟它炒到非常非常的透。如果你炒得不透，这椰丝很快就会臭酸。So ladies and gentlemen, remember you have to stir your coconut and you have to cook it through. Otherwise, your coconut will turn sour very very quickly. You have to cook it through. 好，大家请看哈，这椰丝呢现在就煮得很透了。这个时候我们可以准备一点的粟米粉。这个是一小匙的粟米粉，加入一大匙的水。This is one teaspoon of corn flour. You add in one tablespoon of water. This is for thickening. 好，大家请看哈，我们的椰丝就已经很透了。这时候我们就可以加入我们的粟粉水。这粟粉水就是用一小匙的粟粉，加入一大匙的水，跟它搅拌均匀。你看这个椰丝哈，它本来是很散的。一加入了这个粟粉水呢，它就会比较有粘性。等一下我们包的时候呢，就会比较容易。You can see that after adding in the corn flour water, the coconut is more starchy. It can hold better. So later on when you want to roll, it can stick better. Now it is already cooked. You can turn off the fire. 那现在这个椰丝就已经好了哈，我们就可以跟它拿起来。好，我们现在就让它冷一冷 ，leave it to cool before we use it.好，各位朋友，要做这个龟壳大药，首先呢，我们就要烧热一个不粘底的盆哦，最好就是差不多是6到7寸，不要太大哈、哦。So this is a non-stick pan, which is about 6 to 7 inches in diameter. Just get ready a bit of oil, 加入一点点的油。我们第一块的时候放多一点点的油，先跟它拿来转一转。So for the first piece, you put in a bit more oil, just till it.Make it even, then you remove the oil. 然后把多余的油倒出来。它上面只是有一点点的油而已。然后在这里呢，我们就是把我们刚才的那个面糊跟它拿一搅拌均匀，然后我们就可以倒一点下去。Then you pour in a bit of the prepared batter, and then you use your hands slowly, you tilt it to form into a skin. 然后就是这个样子哦。我们跟它拿来转一转，直到它能够成为一片薄薄的皮，看起来就好像做那个薄饼一样哈。It is just like making spring roll skin, or you can say it looks like making a pancake. It should be pancake consistency. If you feel that it's a bit too thick, when you pour it down, you find that it's very difficult to tilt.That means it is a bit too thick. What you can do is just add in a little bit more water. 所以记得哦，如果你觉得你这个皮啊，你倒进去了以后啊，它很难转，你转的时候它很难流，就是说它太过浓，那么你加多一点点的水吧。好，这个时候呢，你就这样给它煮一煮，直到它能够，大家看到吗？它能够自动的离开。它自动能够离开，你看它上面的皮呢就已经全部熟了。当它的颜色全部变了的时候，就是说这个皮已经熟了。那这个时候我们可以准备另外一个碟子，就是把它轻轻的这样给它倒出来。So just pour it out. Over here we can put in some filling. 在这里现在我们呢就可以放一点点的椰丝，放椰丝在我们的皮的上面，跟它弄得很整齐的。然后大家请看 ，just put the filling at one side of the pancake, and then you cover up. 看到吗？跟它盖起来以后，跟它拉一拉，它就紧了哈。在这里呢，我的两端我们再跟它折起来，两端跟它折起来，就好像包我们的春卷一样， 就是这样卷起来，很快的它就变成了一块很漂亮的龟卡达亚，我们也叫做龟达达。大家请看哦，这个香叶椰丝卷它是甜的，如果你不能够吃甜的话，或者是不喜欢吃甜的话，你可以把整个东西变成咸的。要怎样变呢？就是刚才那个香叶我们就不用香叶，就是把350ml 的香叶水改成奶水，或者是改成普通的水，那么它的皮就是白色的啦。然后里面的馅料呢，你就可以用咸的馅料，你可以用一点肉丝啊、冬菇丝啊，还有一些那个生姜啊，就是莽姜哦之类来炒，炒成一个咸的馅料放在里面，它就变成了一个咸的一个卷，也是很好吃的哦。So you can always turn your kuih kedaya or kuih dadar into a savory pancake. If you want to make into a savory pancake, you just need to change the pandan water into milk. You can just use 350 ml of milk or just plain water. So you find that the pancake is white in color. Then for the filling, you change it into savory filling using shredded meat, sengguang, or you can use some mushroom.Anything that's savory, you fry and then you wrap it in. Yes, anything that's savory, like popiah filling, you can use. And it becomes a savory pancake. So I hope you like it.